Welcome back to Great Adventure. I'm your host, Mark Guido, and I am officially in the middle of nowhere, deep in the Mojave Desert of southeastern California. We've spent a couple of episodes wandering around the Sonoran Desert, but now we're headed for the Mojave National Preserve. So come along for the ride. This particular middle of nowhere is on the map as Amboy, California. Roy Crowell pretty much owned the entire town when he opened up this gas station, motel, and cafe in 1938 as a pit stop along the old Route 66. Kind of hard to believe that there's still an operating post office over here over my left shoulder. I'm actually going to pay the $4.99 a gallon to top off my gas tank because I'm actually heading into an even more remote area that doesn't have any gas stations whatsoever. It's almost hard to believe that in order to get the electricity here from many, 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 many miles away, Roy's son-in-law actually put the poles in himself, just carrying them out in the desert in a Studebaker pickup. Middle of nowhere is known as Kelso. That absolutely gorgeous structure behind me is the Kelso Depot. It was built in the 1920s. This is the start of the Kelso SEMA grade, which was the steepest grade on the railroad between Los Angeles and Utah. Here they had helper locomotives to push the trains up that grade. They also had a watering station for the steam locomotives. It was also too long a stretch to go without a meal car on the train, so for passenger trains, they also had a restaurant here, as well as employee housing. Today, Kelso Depot serves as the main visitor center for the Mojave National Preserve. Now, today is November 11th, 2018, Veterans Day. It's also the 100th anniversary to the day of the signing of the armistice that ended the Great War, World War I. How perfect, then, that we are camped only 100 yards from Sunrise Rock. The reason being that cross on the top of the rock memorializes all the men who died fighting in World War I. It was first erected in the 1930s by some members of the local VFW. However, in the 1990s and the early 2000s, it became the subject of a very contentious court battle over the placement of a religious symbol on public land. A district court held that the cross needed to be removed. That decision was upheld by the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals. Congress thereafter enacted a number of measures to try to prevent the removal of the cross. They denied any funding to the National Park Service for any cross removal efforts. They also passed a land swap that would transfer 5 acres of private land within the National Preserve to the National Park Service in exchange for this 1 acre going to the VFW. Now, it went all the way to the Supreme Court, which held by a 5-4 decision that the cross did not need to be removed. However, the land swap has taken place, and this cross, which now memorializes all veterans who have died in all wars, now is on privately held land. And to all of our veterans on this Veterans Day, thank you so much for your service.
Morning. Well, we awoke this morning to 35 degrees and very brisk north winds, which we're going to have to face today as a headwind as we head up to St. George, where we have reservations at Snow Canyon State Park. We hope you've really enjoyed coming along with us on this very short visit to the Mojave National Preserve. Much too short, in my opinion. This is a beautiful place, and we will definitely be back. But if you're not yet one of our grand adventurers, come along with us to Snow Canyon by hitting that subscribe button. Ring that notification bell. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up down below. Also down below, you'll find the comment section where we always love to hear from you. Until next time, please remember, life is nothing but a grand adventure. We'll see you soon.